Together, Kamdi Sosani and Saman Arbabi created a parody newscast beamed into Iran by the Voice of America. It's been dubbed the Persian Daily Show. Kamdi and Saman join me now. Let me just start with the title of this show, the name of the show. Explain it and explain the significance, because just the name itself is very important.
Well, when you turn on your TV in Iran, sitting in your living room, and you would like to see international channels, like our popular VOA channel, what you see is they jam the satellite. What you see is a static.
That's called static or parasit in Farsi. So we kind of stashed a name underneath parasit.
So basically, if you want to show, if you want to jam the satellites, and people, they're forced to see a static, why don't we make a show that's called static?
You had the Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, on the program, and you start off in a funny way, but look how quickly it turns.
We were supposed to do this way earlier. We assume you were too busy taking down dictators. since you were gone, you know, I think 4 or 5 dictators are gone too. And then we go to our audience question. Do you believe the Islamic Republic of Iran is a dictatorship?
I do. I believe the regime is a dictatorship, and I think it's becoming even more of one. In fact, I think it is moving toward being a military dictatorship.
Explain how you think parody and satire help.
I believe when you use parody, you can deliver any message that you want in today's media, because with all the guidelines that the media have, you know, these days, journalists are really having a tough time to tell the truth.
Now, both born in Iran.
Both born in Iran.
And yet, as the Irish guy at the table, you must have a little Irish in your blood, because you actually conceived the idea for this show over Guinness.
Guinness, yeah, we're still waiting for that sponsorship. Yeah. I don't know if anyone's watching it.
I've mentioned Guinness a lot, but nobody's contacted us saying thank you very much.
I'll help work on that. You know, I have a closer family tie, so we can work that out, or we can have one. Hell, I want you to listen here. I want you to listen. You know, Fareed Zakaria just went to Iran, and he sat down with the person who is often at the end of your jokes and your not-so-jokes.
Yes.
Mahmoud Ahmadinejad, yes, he's the chief writer for the program. Listen to this piece of the interview.
In Iran, we do not have political prisoners. The government has never arrested and imprisoned people.
Now, on the one hand, that has to infuriate you, just infuriate you to listen to him lie.
No, it's great.
Yet, on the other hand, if you're running a show that's parody and satire, that's like, you know, thank you, God.
This is a follow-up joke to what Ahmadinejad said in Colombia. There are no gays in Iran.
Yeah,
so this is like, once a joke works, you just keep translating it into a different thing.
This guy is amazing. It's like I'm here in John King, USA, and everybody sees that. You're John King, there's a sign back here, and I'm this Persian dude, and he's that guy. And I'm like, ladies and gentlemen, I'm in Larry King. It's that, the lies are that obvious.
You're having fun, but what is the goal? What do you hope your fun and the parody and the pointed political message within it, what do you want the effect to be?
You know, going back to what Kamdi said earlier, when you use parody, you're disarming yourself and the person you're trying to reach out to. So then people become more receptive to your message and what you have to say. Our motto is to use common sense, because the government's an insult to our common sense. The lies and the ridiculous stuff that you hear out of the government is completely just outrageous. And
that's a great line, by the way.
Thank you. I love you.
That's a great line.
So we use common sense to fight them back, and parody is just a tool that allows even the people who don't agree with us to sit down and try to listen to us. We're not trying to change any governments. We're not trying to lead any movements. We're just trying to put some common sense into a government that has no respect for it for the last 32 years.
And here's the thing. People in Iran have only one channel of communication, and that's state media. What we do, we give them another angle, another perspective on some whatever story that they hear every week, so they have options to choose from, so they can have a broader perspective to the whole thing.
If you said these things about Ahmadinejad, about the Ayatollahs, about the regime in Iran, You would end up in one of those prisons that he says doesn't exist.
Right. We wouldn't exist either.
Yeah. Do you worry at all that those who watch you on the receiving end, since that is a message the government does not want them to hear, obviously you believe in the power of communication, of freedom of speech, and you wish your audience there had it fully. Do you ever worry?
Of course. The kids in Iran are by far more brave than we can imagine. Like, the view outside of my living room is the Capitol building. So for us, it's easier to sit here and you know, live our lives. It's far more difficult to actually be controlled by an oppressive regime like that.